Hello dear students, welcome back again to our chemistry class. Now in this session we will be going to learn about that is the magnetic properties of solids. It is our 8th session of the solid state. In this session we will be going to learn about magnetic properties of solids. Here it containing paramagnetic properties as well as diamagnetic properties, ferromagnetic and then anti-ferromagnetic. Last one is ferrimagnetic. Okay. Dear students, first one, magnetic properties of solids. In this magnetic properties of solids, the electrons revolve around it, or the electrons revolve continuously and it produces the magnetic moment. Electrons revolve continuously and it produces the magnetic moment. Here the two cases arises. That is, the first one case is electrons, it is revolve around its own axis. Electron revolve around its own axis. And then another one is electron revolve around the nucleus. Electron revolve around the nucleus. Dear students, here the magnetic properties of solids. In solids, the movement of electrons, it produces the magnetic field. Here, these electrons are having the movement two types. One is along its own axis, another one is around that is the nucleus in an orbitary motion. Here, these two types of motion, or here the these two types of movement, it is associated with the magnetic moment. It is associated with the magnetic moment. That magnetic moment, it is represented by mu. Magnetic moment, it is represented by mu, and its formula is root of n into bracket n plus 2, and its unit is Bohr magneton. Its unit is Bohr magneton. Here it n represents, that is the number of unpaired electrons. N represents number of unpaired electron. Suppose here the number of unpaired electron is 1 and then magnetic moment value is 1 point something. Similarly, that is n is equal to 2 and then it is having the magnetic moment is 2 point something. Here just you have to remember, dependent upon the number of unpaired electron, and then answer will be, that is, if suppose one number of unpaired electron and the answer is 1 point something, and then suppose it is the two number of unpaired electron, then the answer will be 2 point something, and then similarly 3, and then the answer is for the magnetic moment of 3 unpaired electron, that is the 3 point something. This is about the first one, that is the magnetic properties of solid. It involves in, that is, the electrons. Next one we will go for, that is the types of magnetic properties. Dear students, already you learned for your previous session, that is in the PUC first, you know only that is the two types of magnetic properties. What are those? One is a paramagnetic, another one is a diamagnetic. And then in this session, means that is for your second year purpose, they have add again extra three types of magnetic properties. Now you have a total magnetic properties, that is a 5 number. So first one is a paramagnetic property. What is meant by paramagnetic property? See here, paramagnetic property means when a substance is placed in an external magnetic field. When a substance, it is placed in an external magnetic field and it is weakly attracted by the magnetic field. Here, this is your substance and then this is your magnet is there, okay? So now it is containing the north as well as south pole. So here, this is just you have to imagine, it is our magnet and it is our substance. These substance, it is weakly attracted by the magnetic field. These substance, it is weakly attracted by the magnetic field. It is known as paramagnetic property. And then here, the paramagnetic property, it is totally dependent upon, that is, the number of unpaired electron. Paramagnetic property, it is totally depend upon the number of unpaired electron. Unpaired electron means it containing, that is, a single electron, number of unpaired electron. This magnetic property, it is totally dependent upon these number of unpaired electron. See an example for that is the O2 as well as copper plus 2 state, as well as Fe plus 3 state. These are the best example for the paramagnetic property. So now I am taking one simple example, that is Fe plus 3. Okay. So now, what is the atomic number of iron? What is its atomic number? That is the 26. What's the electronic configuration for this iron? That is argon 3d6 and then 4s2. It is only in the ground state. Now I am telling here, it's the electronic configuration for iron. But what is our example? Fe plus 3 is there. So therefore, Fe plus 3 means it loses, that is the 3 electrons. So now what will be the electronic configuration for the Fe plus 3? See here, it is the argon 3d6 4s2. Here Fe plus 3 is there. Fe plus 3 means what you have to do? To remove 3 electrons. So now here 2 is left out, another 1 is goes out. What is the remaining? 5 electrons. That is the 3d5. Okay, 3d5 is there. Now I am going to write, that is the d subshell. D subshell, it containing, that is the how many orbitals? 5 orbitals. This is the 1, dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. Totally how many orbitals are there? 5 orbitals. Okay, in the d subshell. And then how many number of electrons? This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now it is best example for the paramagnetic properties. Dear students, artha aita? Paramagnetic property antandre enri? Idu one substance, it is weakly attracted by the magnetic field. Magnet hatra tandre antandra a substance enantandre just light age asta attract aagtati, but strong age attract agangilla. Adakke naavu enante kareethivu antandra paramagnetic property. Paramagnetic property antandre main yavudra mel depend agirtatri, that is unpaired electrons. Okay, it containing one or more number of unpaired electrons. Now we will go for, that is the second type of property. Second type of property is, that is the diamagnetic property. The diamagnetic property means it is opposes for the paramagnetic property. It is just opposite form of the paramagnetic property. So what is the opposite form for the paramagnetic property? Paramagnetic, it containing unpaired electron as well as it is weakly attracted by the magnetic field. And in case of diamagnetic field, the substance, when it is placed in the magnetic field, it is strongly attracted by this magnetic field. Is known as a diamagnetic property. Understand aita? Diamagnetic property antandre ri one substance anna magnet hatra tandaga adu strong agi attract aayt antandra adakke naave enante kareethivi diamagnetic property. Here it is mainly dependent upon, that is the paired electrons. Means it containing, that is the paired number of electrons. Go for the example for this one. Here that is the N2, H2, Zn plus 2, NaCl, C6H6, etc. These are the best example for the diamagnetic property. Dear students, here you have to see about, that is the diamagnetic property. In this one, very well example is, that is NaCl. Okay. And then NaCl means it is containing, that is the 23, and then this is about the plus 17, and then count the number of this one, that is it gives, that is a even number, and then C6H6, and this is 12 into 6. Okay, plus this is about the 1 into 6, and then here also equal number, and then next one Zn plus 2. You can go for Zn plus 2. What about the atomic number for zinc? Yes, 30. Okay, atomic number for zinc is 30. Its electronic configuration is argon 3d10, and then this is about the 4s2. Argon 3d10, 4s2. And the next one, Zn plus 2. Zn plus 2 means you have to remove, that is the 2 electrons. So now, in case of Zn plus 2, it is having the electronic configuration Zn plus 2 argon, it is the 3d10. Okay, 3d10 means what? Here again you have to draw, that is the d orbital. Dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. Here it is containing how many number of electrons? 10 number of electrons. So now you have to substitute or you have to fill these number of electrons into this one. Okay. So now here one, according to Wundt's rule. What is the Wundt's rule? All the electrons are singly occupied. Then you can go to the pair. So now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is about the 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now here all the electrons are paired up. So therefore it is known as a diamagnetic property. Understand aita? Diamagnetic property antandre electrons ellananu paired agirbeku. Illi ond hint kodtinri student. ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೀ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಡಯಾಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿಯನ್ನು ಹೆಂಗೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಡಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್? ಡೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಟೂ. ಟೂ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪೇಡ್ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ಪೇಡ್ ನಂಬರ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪೇಡ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಡಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೀ ಡಯಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಟೂ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗಿರಬೇಕು? ಪೇಡ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಪ್ಯಾರಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೀ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಿರಬೇಕಲ್ಲಿ? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಪೇಡ್ ಆಗಿರಬಾರ್ದು. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಪೇಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಮೂವ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಫೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಇವಾಗ ನೀವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತು ತೊಗೊಂಡಿರಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಡ್ರಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಥರ ಬಿಹೇವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಹೌದಾ? ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದತ್ರಿ. ನೀವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ನಂತರ ಆ ವಸ್ತು ಇನ್ನೂ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತೈತ್ರಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫೆರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಸಿ ಹಿಯ, ವೆನ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, they are also strongly attracted by that magnetic field. Later, you can remove that external magnetic field, but the substance is acts as a magnetic behavior. Say here, take this one substance, okay? This substance, it is placed in an external magnetic field. At that time, this substance is strongly attracted by this magnet. So see here. Okay. Then it acts as a magnetic behavior. It is having a magnetic behavior. Later, you can remove this magnetic field. What will be the property of this substance? This substance, it is also having, or it is shows, even after removing of magnetic field, it shows the magnetic property. So this type of magnetic property is known as ferromagnetic property. All of you understood what is meant by ferromagnetic property? So now, here the example for this one, iron, cobalt, nickel. These are the best example for the ferromagnetic substances. And the next one is, see here, in this one, the spins are aligned like this one. Okay, spins are aligned like this one in the ferromagnetic properties. And the next one is, here ferromagnetic property is there. It is looking like this one, okay? Because here the spins are aligned likewise in a only aligned direction, so therefore it shows that is a ferromagnetic property diagram. And the next property is antiferromagnetic. What is meant by antiferromagnetic? Ferromagnetic, and then this is the antiferromagnetic. Anti-ferromagnetic means the magnetic moment of the different domains. Magnetic moment of the different domains are aligned in opposite direction. So therefore, that effect cancel with each other. Aligned with magnetic domains are aligned with opposite direction. Or see here, this is the plus, minus, and this is the minus, plus. These are cancelled with each other. Then this is known as anti-ferromagnetic. A good example for this one, oxides of manganese, that is the MnO, MnO2, Mn2O3. These are the best example for the ferromagnetic. Anti-ferromagnetic substance, dear student, just in and pit code, domains of the substance or substance domains in irtavantandra opposite direction olgirtavri. Opposite direction olgidaga ondukond cancel aagtavu. Cancel adu antandra avag en torustate antandra anti-ferromagnetic property na torustate. See here, the alliance like this one. This is about the above and this is about the below, means in opposite direction. And then our next point is, that is the ferromagnetic property. Ferromagnetic property means what? Here, if the magnetic moment of the different domains are aligned in opposite direction in unequal number. Domains are arranged, aligned, but it is in unequal number. So therefore, that substance, it is weakly attracted by the applied magnetic field. So it is known as ferromagnetic. For example, is here, that is a magnetite. So ferromagnetic antandre endri, see this diagram here, the domains are arranged in unequal numbers, okay, arranged in opposite, but these are in unequal number. So nodri, here also upward, downward, here the upward and then downward, but these are in unequal number. Adre even antandre ri equal numbers ke irangila. So now again here you can take like this one and then like this one, means these are in unequal numbers. So therefore, its property is known as ferromagnetic property. Dear students, ferromagnetic property antandre endri, magnetic moments of the different domains are aligned in opposite directions in unequal numbers. The substance get weakly attracted by the applied magnetic field. Just you have to remember here, that is the unequal numbers are there. This is about the ferromagnetic property. And then see here, in the paramagnetic ordering, the spins are arranged like this one because it containing unpaired electron. And then in the anti-ferromagnetic ordering, that is the arranged in means opposite direction exactly. And in ferromagnetic ordering, these all are in only similar direction, that is the NS-NS that wise. And then here ferromagnetic ordering, these are arranged in unequal numbers. This is about, that is a simplified form of the magnetic properties. And then next one, here one question will arises, okay. This question is from, that is a NCERT textbook. Here, what type of substances would make better permanent magnets, ferromagnetic or ferromagnetic? Justify your answer. What is the question, dear students? What type of substances would make better permanent magnets? Yav type of substance anna navu permanent magnet annagi maadabodu, ferromagnetic or ferromagnetic? Justify your answer. Here, ferromagnetic substance would make better permanent magnets. Ferromagnetic substances anna navu en maadabodu antandra better permanent magnetic moment annagi maadabodu. Why? Because here, in solid state, okay, in solid state, the metal ions of ferromagnetic substances are grouped together into small regions. In solid, okay, ferromagnetic substances are divided into very small regions or very small. This is known as, that is the domains. It is known as a domains. And here, each domain cities acts as in tiny magnets. These acts as tiny magnets. Here in this one, again, in an unmagnified piece of ferromagnetic substances, the domains are randomly oriented. Means here, in unmagnified, means that is the absence of magnetic field. Absence of magnetic field, these domains are arranged in randomly. Absence of magnetic field, these domains are arranged in randomly. While in presence of magnetic field, in presence of magnetic field, it arranges in uniformly. So this is about our answer. Okay, so therefore here the magnetic field are produces in presence of, that is a ferromagnetic substances, it shows that is a permanent magnet, because here the domains are arranged uniformly. Dear students, ಪೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೈತ್ರಿ, ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೈತಿ, ಪೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲನೂ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತಾವೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಲ್ಲೇನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೀ, ಒಂದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ತೊಗೊಳ್ರಿ, ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸನ್ನು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಆಗಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೇವೆ ರೀ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೊಮೆನ್ಸ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಡೊಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ರೀ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡೊಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎನ್ ಥಿನಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಆ ಡೊಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾವ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಥಿನಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ ರೀ. ಇನ್ ಅಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ಲಿ. ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಕ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇಲ್ಲದೇ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಎತ್ತ ಬೇಕಾದಂಥ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವ ರೀ. ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ಅವು ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಿಹೇವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಅರೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಡರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೊಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಪರ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಹಿಯರ್ ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. Why it persists a magnetic property even after removal of the magnetic field? Because here ferromagnetic substance, what is the ferromagnetic substance? Ferromagnetic substance is nothing but when substance it is placed in an external magnetic field, it is strongly attracted by that magnetic field, and then you can remove that external magnetic field, but that substance is also acts as an magnetic field or magnetic behavior. So therefore this ferromagnetic substances, it shows the permanent magnetic property. Okay, and this is about our session is over regarding to magnetic properties of the solids. ಇಲ್ಲೇನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಯ್ತ್ರಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೋ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಫೈವ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್, ಡಯಾಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್, ಆ್ಯಂಟಿ ಫೆರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಪೆರಿಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ